Welcome to the second lecture in the third module on general frameworks. We are looking at data flow frameworks that go beyond bitvector frameworks. In this part of the lecture, we want to look at something called strongly live variables analysis. So we want to look at the concept of strong liveness analysis. Recall that when we did live variables analysis, we realized that we could use it to perform some dead code elimination. And because of that dead code elimination, the liveness information changes and we can redo live variables analysis because some variables cease to be live. So we can do further dead code elimination. So we could have a sequence of liveness analysis followed by dead code elimination, followed by liveness analysis. Strong liveness avoids doing multiple rounds of liveness and dead code elimination. What it essentially does is that it captures the effect of deadness and computes a transitive closure of deadness information. It does not declare a variable to be live if there exists some sequence of liveness and dead code elimination in which the variable could be declared to be dead. So we want to look at now what is strong liveness analysis. So a variable is strongly live. This is how it is defined. If it is used in a statement other than an assignment statement, so which is, it's used in a condition, it's passed as a parameter, some such thing, there is some use statement which does not define a variable, this situation is same as simple liveness. So this is one of the conditions which makes a variable strongly live. The other condition that makes the variable strongly live is if it is used in an assignment statement, on the right hand side of the assignment statement, defining a variable that is strongly live. So this requirement that the left hand side variable of the assignment should be strongly live, this did not exist in simple liveness. So this is, in this situation, for this condition, strong live variables analysis is different from simple liveness. So we define live variables analysis using gen and kill. So what amounts to killing the liveness information? So an assignment statement, an input statement or boundary information. So an assignment statement to a variable X will amount to killing the liveness of variable X. When we input a variable or when we read a variable from input, liveness of that variable is killed. Or liveness of variable may be killed in the boundary information. If it's a local variable, it's not considered live at the end of the program. So this killing of the information is same as simple liveness. There is no difference. The difference is in the generation of liveness information. A direct use or a use for defining values that are strongly live is what gives rise to generation of liveness information. Let's understand this through an example. So there are, we have three cases here. In the first case, we have X being used, X being read. So therefore, we will have in strong liveness, we will have nothing live here at the end of the statement. And then we will have X as live. And now, as an effect of this statement, we will not change anything in the liveness. This assignment to Y would have killed liveness of Y, but Y is not live here, so X will continue to be live here. If we did simple liveness, we discover that we get the same result. We will get empty set here, then X, and then X. Now consider the same situation with a simple change that instead of print X, now we have print Y. In the strong liveness analysis, we will once again mark Y as live. And now this liveness of y will be killed by our assignment to y, and we will declare x to be live. So this is the liveness information computed by strong liveness. Observe that this is same as the information that will be computed by simple. So there is no difference here. Let's look at the third situation. In the third situation, we have z being passed. Now we have assignment y is equal to x, and z is being passed as a parameter to print. This makes z live in strong liveness analysis. Now we observe that this z is live and this left hand side variable y is not live, and therefore we cannot make x as live here. So strong liveness information will remain only z. Contrast this with simple liveness. In simple liveness, we would not check whether the left hand side is live or not. We will simply declare the variables appearing on the right hand side to be live. So simple liveness will declare z, x as live, whereas strong liveness will declare only z as live. Note here that this x, liveness of this x in strong liveness, hasn't come because of the left hand side. Left hand side variable y is not live here. So this statement is effectively ignored by strong liveness, and the liveness of x is propagated from here to here. Because the statement does not define x, so this does not affect the liveness of x at all. So effectively, this statement is ignored, and in this situation also the statement is ignored, except that in this situation the data flow values are still same as simple liveness, but in this case data flow values are different. Because the liveness information after the statement is different. So this is a strong liveness for us. This is where the situation differs. Recall that a variable is live at a program point if its current value is likely to be used later. That's the intuition in strong liveness. And simple liveness as well, except that simple liveness computes an over approximation of these values. We want to compute the smallest set of variables that are live. So here is an example in which we had performed several rounds of live variables analysis, followed by dead code elimination, followed by another round of liveness analysis, followed by another round of dead code elimination, etc. So our live variables analysis declares every use of a variable as useful. So live variables analysis says that A, B, C are live here. A and B are live here because they appear on the right hand side of this statement, and C is live here because it appears in the right hand side of this statement and is not killed by this assignment because the left hand side here is T1, and therefore A, B, C are live. And A, B, C are live here, and this N is used in the condition, so N also becomes live. So A, B, C and variable N, these are the four variables that are live here. And now along this back edge, this data flow value is propagated, and A, B, C, N are live at the exit of the statement. Although the liveness of A is killed in this statement, A also appears on the right hand side, and therefore A, B, C, N are live here, and we have A, B, C, N as live here. So this is the information computed by simple liveness. By contrast, what strong liveness does is the following. Strong liveness checks the liveness of the result before declaring the operands to be live. So, for example, at this statement, before saying C is live, strong liveness asks, is the left-hand side variable A is it live? So, it turns out that there is no use of A later. So, if there is no use of A later, it means that this is going to be deleted as dead code. And if this is going to be deleted as dead code, then our saying that C is live here
is an over approximation. We need not say that C is live. Similarly, C is not live here and T1 is not live here. And because T1 is not live here, it means that this left hand side also does not have a subsequent use. And therefore, we cannot mark A and B also live. So in strong liveness, we say that none of the variables A, B, C is live here, which is easy to see because whatever is being done here, the computation being done in these two statements does not lead to any computation or any observable difference in the execution of the program. As far as the result of the program is concerned, what is printed by the program on the output or what is returned to the calling function, there is no difference. So, we do not have A, B and C as live here. This statement does not use any variable anyway. Now, here we had A being used in a condition, so A becomes live. However, B and C do not become live. So here we have A live, and now because of this, N becomes live. So now in strong liveness, we have A and N as live. We do not have B and C as live. So we have A and N as live here. Here we have A and N as live. And here we have A and N as live. So what it essentially says is that although we are assigning a value to B and we are assigning a value to C, if we remove these statements, nothing will change in the program because these values do not contribute to producing any output of the program. Yes, these values are used in computing a value of A here, but this value of A is not used and therefore these values of B and C are not required. This is the effect that we had got by doing rounds of liveness analysis and dead code elimination, but strong liveness captures this effect directly. So, as I said before, A is dead here, so therefore T1 and C become dead, and because T1 becomes dead, therefore A and B are dead. In what I'm trying to say is that strong liveness essentially captures transitive closure of the deadness information, thereby computing smaller amount of information for liveness. And therefore, strong liveness analysis is more precise than simple liveness analysis. So these are the data flow equations for strongly live variables analysis. We say in N is a function of out of N, and we will define this flow function here. And out N is, if N is end, the out is BI. Otherwise, out N is a union of in of all the successors. So these equations are identical to what we have for simple live variables analysis. The change is here. So we define the flow function fn here, and we do a case analysis on different kinds of statements. So first kind of a statement is y is an assignment statement to y. Y is equal to e. E could be any expression. It could involve variables. It could involve just the constants, or it may just be a single variable. This could well have been y is equal to x. All of these are abstracted by y is equal to e. So we're saying when the statement is y is equal to e and y is in x, x is the parameter that is being passed to the flow function and it is obtained from out of n, which means that this captures a situation when the left hand side of the assignment is live after the statement. What happens in that case? In that case, we say because the left hand side is y, from the liveness information, we must remove y. Y ceases to be live. Note that here we have said y is in x. So y is removed from x, and all the operands of the expression, which are variables, so the intersection of operands and variables, all those variables appearing on the right hand side of the assignment are declared to be live. Note that this is the kill part of the equation and this is the gen part of the equation. So we are writing the data flow equation, or we are writing the flow function in a slightly different format. I encourage you to find out how to change this definition of flow function to that of a simple liveness analysis. The second statement that we consider is the statement is input of y, meaning we are reading the value of y from the input. Clearly, the previous value in y is of no use, so we are going to overwrite that value. So therefore, we simply kill the liveness of y from, we remove it from x, nothing is generated. So gen is empty in this case. If we have a use of y, then this is not an assignment statement, so no liveness is killed. So here kill is empty and gen is just y. So we just add y to the set of variables that are live after the statement. In every other case, this flow function is an identity function. It does not add anything to the liveness, does not remove anything from the liveness. So both gen and kill are empty sets. It simply propagates the argument value as the output of the function. So this is the data flow equation for strong live variables analysis. Please try to convert it into the flow function definition for simple liveness analysis. So if y is not strongly live, the assignment is skipped using the otherwise clause. So if y is not live, y is not in x, this condition is not satisfied and it's an assignment statement, so it comes to the otherwise clause. So what are the properties of strongly live variables analysis? So what is L cap? What is the component lattice for a single variable for strong liveness analysis? Is strongly live variables analysis a bit vector framework? Is strongly live variables analysis a separable framework? Is strongly live variables analysis distributive? Are the flow functions distributive? Are they monotonic? So we want to answer all these questions. So L cap, the component lattice, happens to be identical to that of any bit vector data flow frameworks. It's a lattice of 1 and 0, except that 1 is weaker than 0. Note that empty set is the initialization, the top value is the empty set, the bottom value is the universal set. So therefore, the component lattice for a single variable has the bit 1 for the variable. A strong live variables analysis is a bit vector framework. This might look like a bit of tricky question. We are representing data flow information using bit vectors. So it might look like this is a bit vector framework, but a bit vector framework is defined not just as a framework in which the information is represented using bit vectors. It is a framework in which the operations can be implemented as bit vector operations and or not set difference. We observe here that this requires a check. This requires a check. This is not, this cannot be represented by and or not operations alone. We need an if something. If this is true, then do this. We need some kind of an implication. So this is not represented simply by bit vector operations. So this is not a bit vector framework. Is strongly live variables analysis a separable framework? The answer is obviously no, because we compute the liveness of variables occurring on the right hand side of an assignment from the liveness of the variable occurring on the left hand side. If the left hand side variable is not live, we do not declare the variables occurring in the right hand side to be live. So this is not a separable framework. By contrast, simple live variables analysis is a separable framework. Simple liveness analysis is a bit vector framework because operations can be defined simply in terms of three bit vector operations: difference, union, and intersection. Is strongly live variables analysis distributive? Is it monotonic? This is interesting. Although this is not a bit vector framework, although this is not a separable framework, it turns out that strongly live variables analysis is distributive, unlike constant propagation. So constant propagation is also not separable. It's also not a bit vector framework, but constant propagation is non-distributive. By contrast, strongly live variables analysis is distributive, and hence it is monotonic. We will try to prove the distributivity condition. The distributivity condition says that for every flow function fn, when we apply fn to x1 union x2, where x1 and x2 are sets of variables that have been declared to be strongly live, when we apply fn to the union of x1 and x2, the value that we get is same as if we were to apply fn to x1 separately and x2 separately and take a union of the two sets. This is the distributivity condition. For monotonicity, this is replaced by less than equal to. So therefore, if we can prove distributivity, it's easy to see that monotonicity automatically follows. So why, before we look into a mathematical argument why it is distributive, we also need to look at the intuition as to why we expect this framework to be distributive. And the answer is simple. The value of this function fn does not depend on the argument x. So what I mean is the following. Let's look at this flow function. Here, the value what is declared to be live or whose liveness is removed depends only on the particular statement, only in particular on the left hand side. We are using this x only to do a case analysis. Note that our kill in every case is either y or empty set, and gen in every case is either the operands appearing on in e or y if it is a use y statement. So gen and kill have only two possibilities: either operands appearing on the right hand, gen is either operands appearing on the right hand side or y, and kill is either y or empty set. This does not, the result of gen and kill does not depend on x. The choice, there are two choices, and which one do we choose depends on x. So this is the intuition why incomparable results cannot be produced, because a fixed set of variables are excluded or included. So whether a variable is excluded or included, this is decided by the argument x. But which variable is excluded and which variable is included is fixed and can be determined by the statement alone, and does not this set, which variables are excluded, which variables are included, this set does not depend on x at all. So formally, we prove this for input y, input use and ye statements, and empty statements independently. For input y statement, the argument is actually very simple. If we are reading the value of y, it means that liveness of y is killed. So therefore, the flow function is whatever is the argument, from the argument, just remove y. Please look at the definition of flow function here. For the input y, we are saying whatever is the argument, from that we just remove y. So we write it as x1 union x2 minus y. And because y is being removed from the union of x1 and x2, y can be independently removed from x1 and x2. In other words, set difference
distributes over set union. So we can write x1 minus y and x2 minus y. Note that for this statement, x1 minus y is the result of fn of x1, and this is the result of fn of x2, and therefore fn of x1 union x2 is equal to fn of x1 union fn of x2. For your statement, the situation is similar, except that this set difference operation is replaced by set union operation. Again, union distributes over union. We are adding y to the union of x1 and x2. So we might as well add y to x1 separately and to x2 separately and then take a union. This gives us, the first bracket gives us fn of x1 and the second bracket gives us fn of x2. So in this case also, fn of x1 union x2 is equal to fn of x1 union fn of x2. For empty statements, the flow function is an identity function. So what we get is fn of x1 union x2 is same as x1 union x2, but then fn of x1 is x1 and fn of x2 is x2. So x1 union x2 is same as fn x1 union fn x2. So in this case also the distributivity condition is trivially satisfied. So we have proved these three statements. Now we want to prove it for the fourth statement, an assignment statement, y is equal to some assignment statement. Here we are referring to small y. Let capital Y be the set of variables that appear on the right hand side. Now there are three cases. Y is both in x1 and x2. Note that we have to write this equation, x1 and x2. So y is in both of them. Y is only one of them and not in the second one of them. And y is in neither of them. There could be a fourth case that y is in x2 but not in x1, but the argument remains same. There is no difference in the argument. So let's go case by case. So let's take the first case. Y is contained in both x1 and x2. In this case, we try to simplify fn of x1 union x2. So what we have to do is we have to take this argument x1, x2. From that, we have to remove small y and add the set capital Y, which is the set of variables appearing on the right hand side. Now again, this y distributes over the union, so we have x1 minus y union x2 minus y. Now this capital Y, this union also distributes over this union, so we can pull this y inside the two brackets and we can say x1 minus y union capital Y, and then we can say x2 minus y union capital Y, which is same as, so this bracket is same as fn of x1 and this bracket is same as fn of x2. So therefore we find that fn of x1 union x2 is same as fn of x1 union fn of x2. Let's look at the second case. In the second case, again we begin by expanding this in the same way. We remove y from x1 union x2 and add capital Y. Note that we are saying that y is not in x2. If y is not in x2, it means that this term x2 minus y will be equal to x2. So we can pull this x2 out of this set difference and pull this y inside this bracket, and we write x1 minus y union y union x2, because this x2 is unaffected by y. Y is not there in x2. Okay. And now because y is not in x2, fn of x2 is identity. Therefore, this is same as fn of x2 and this is same as fn of x1. So once again, fn of x1 union x2 is same as fn of x1 union fn of x2. In the third case, y is not contained in either of them. This is the otherwise clause of the flow function, in which case it is an identity
function, and therefore it trivially follows that fn of x1 union x2 is equal to fn of x1 union fn of x2. So here is a tutorial problem for strongly live variables analysis. I will not explain this to you. I will require you to work it out and try and understand why something is strongly live and why something is not strongly live and how something is declared to be strongly live. The result is there in the slides. And please work it out and see for yourself that you are indeed getting the strong liveness information same as that given in this result. Here is another tutorial problem on strong liveness. Now we want to define something called strongly me must liveness. Instead of viewing liveness information as a map from var to 0, 1 with the lattice 0, 1, view it as a map from var to L cap, where L cap is the me must lattice. Go back to the slides of the previous session and you will find that the me must lattice, we have me as the bottom element, must and no as the two elements on the side, and there is top element at the top. So try to write the data flow equations for me must liveness of strong liveness analysis. Also prove that the flow functions are distributed. With that, our treatment of strong live variables analysis finishes. In the next part of the lecture, we will begin pointer analysis. We will begin by introducing the problem of pointer analysis and looking at the state of the art in pointer analysis.